Hello and welcome back, dear friends. It's me, Odo, and we're back in our campaign of Pathfinder, Wrath of the Righteous. We now have two familiars running around with us, one giving my dear Nenyo a plus in Knowledge Arcana, and the other giving me a plus in Knowledge Nature. Or law nature, or something like that. And we're back here. So he's the traitor. Hey, Woljifs. Okay, so we can't talk to them. They're called Tiefling here as well. I thought they are Tieflings. Well, are you going to tell me who the traitor is? Take a good look at the suspects. The tieflings are tense and ready to reach for their weapons. The only redheads are Melroon and Doffy. The dark-skinned tieflings are Vanya, Doffy, and Melroon. Doffy, Melroon, and Tavy have straight horns, but Tavy is female. Only Vanya and Melroon have green cloaks. Okay. Let's see. We look for a guy with green cloak and with red hair and with long horns. So it must be Melroon. Let's do it like that. This was easy. We'll pay for this. Virgil and Hepsamira will get to you in the end. Can't we do anything about it? Grab him. Take him away for questioning. Okay. This was easy. Wait, 30 minutes have passed. They needed 30 minutes to get him somewhere else. Charisma looks wary, but her earlier tension has clearly lifted. He confessed after 30 minutes. Oh my god. Someone connected to the cult of Baphomet ordered him to steal the moon of the Abyss, and the best idea he could come up with was to drag us into it. He got the scroll to take out the golem. He betrayed us to Irabeth so that he could swipe the amulet in the chaos. He thought we'd get nicked and he'd slink off to meet up with his customer. You've got the moon of the Abyss? Let me look at it one more time. My whole life I've dreamt of holding it in my hands. If only for a second. He said when he got to the window display, the moon was gone. He's lying, of course. He had time to hand the moon off to the person who ordered it, bloody cultists. I don't really give a toss. I'm just glad we got to the bottom of this. So there is no, nothing. So Woljifs got away with it. What are you going to do now? Clear out of this place. Sooner the better. This city is dying. I don't want to die with it. This city would have already died if not for the people who stood up to defend it with weapons in their hands. So defend it. I'm not stopping you. It's your city. But we've always been outsiders here. Why would we fight for you now? Ooh, can I join the family? What are you going to do to the traitor? He'll be sent to visit his distant relatives on their farm. To think about what he did. Any more questions? Can I join the family? That's all you want? You can have your pick of the non-tiefling gangs. You've no need to tread on our territory. The family is for tieflings only. No exceptions. Yeah, well, I have to go. Good decision. I don't plan to hang around long either. Sister Woljif nervously bites his lips. His cheeks are flushed and his tail is swishing through the air. You forgot something. What now? You should be happy to be alive. An apology. You promised to apologize to me loudly in front of everyone. We're alone now, but I will want to hear it. Well, that's. Charisma shrugged indifferently. So sorry, I suppose, for being wrong about you this time. Don't think that just because you didn't act like a jerk this one time, that it cancels out the rest of your record. I know all about you. Till next time, Woljif. Yeah, of course, that's XP. All right, fine. I'm sorry, Woljif. Let's part on good terms. This was 24 XP. How much XP will this give us? It's just 6. Are we dicks? Yeah, of course. And I'm sorry to you too. And to make it up to you, here. And now I'm leaving. Ah, we've got a vault key. Yay! We can get stuff. You made some impression on her. I've never seen Sister Charisma back down before. Listen, Chief, when you've got a spare minute, come see me. I've something I want to discuss with you. But for now, let's get out of here. I don't like sitting below ground when the building above us is ready to crash down on our heads. Okay. Yay. Ooh. It's a trap. Let's disarm it.
Might be trap, might be treasure.
Chief. I got something to show you. Ta-da!
A real beaut, isn't it?
Oh, that cuts me deep, Chief. You and I saw who the traitor was. It's just that when we robbed the shop, I went in first and took what I wanted. Nothing wrong with that. Although, of course, I did think about hiding the moon and just taking myself off somewhere warm when all this blows over. But only because I want to see the world. Is it a crime to want to travel, huh? Is that what counts for treachery these days? Since that night, Chief, Melround didn't even set eyes on it. While he was dealing with the golem, I sneaked past them, and that was that. Do you really not remember it? Oh, I thought you would appreciate it. It's from the old man Fileman, the owner of the Ancient Trees and Wonders shop. It's the pride of his collection. The Moon of the Abyss, an amulet with a rare crystal crafted by an unknown maker. When I think of how much this thing is worth, it makes my head spin. Thieves have their ways. What? So she would slay me right away, you mean? You saw how antsy she was over Canabris and all this. So I did it. I took the Moon of the Abyss. But I didn't go to Erebeth. And Big Sister wouldn't hear my explanations. She doesn't have the time. I even thought I'd hide the moon somewhere, and then when all the noise had died down, I'd go get it and make a run for it. I'm sick of the Tieflings. And they never appreciated me anyway. Why, he asks? It's expensive, pretty. And you know, it's my amulet, actually. Not meaning I stole it, but I mean, this is my inheritance. My grandma and I were poor. All we had was a jewelry box with the moon in it. She used to store it under the floor in the basement, and she'd take it out sometimes just to look at it. She was always nicer when she had a few drinks in her, so I could ask her things then. One time I asked where she got it from, and she said it was from a demon. You know, the demon who was my grandfather. He said the moon was to be passed down. My ma was good for nothing and nobody, so that's why Grandma decided to keep the amulet for me. She used to say it would be mine when I grew up. But she couldn't wait until I grew up. She squandered my inheritance when she became a drunk. Took it to Fileman's shop and pawned it. He gave her some coppers for it, and she didn't even haggle. Just grabbed them and ran back to the tavern before last orders. I've been going to Fileman's to look at the moon ever since I was a kid. He chased me away, but I just kept going back, so eventually he gave up. He didn't skimp on security. The place was like a fortress, so he wasn't worried about a street rat like me pinching anything. Even when I got more skilled, I couldn't get any closer to it. One day, I had no one to go with. Another day, there were only oafs who'd never stolen anything more than a church donation box. But when Charisma had planned everything out, I realized I had a chance to get the moon and move away from here. Maybe to Garand. I hear it's warmer there. I've stayed with the family for too long. Serve anybody, it should be you. And only because I owe you. I don't care if the whole of Canabris drops into the abyss. I don't trust all these crusaders or Galfrey. They just take people's money to spend on crusades, but what's the point? If anyone calls me a crusader, I'll spit in their face just so you know. Even if it's you, Chief. Whatever you think, I owe you. I'm not just a thief. I have my own business selling things. Thanks to you, I'm still in the family, and they, well, I mean, we have the black market sewn up in this city. It's a good way to sell valuables. So, if you need anything, a scroll or something, just say the word. I have a little portal to our people in Erosion. You put a note there, and you get what you need. I can't get you anything big, but what they do have is all high quality. Nothing's too good for you, Chief. What's mine is yours. For a price, of course.